I've, of course, scoured the books, and in the books is very primitive artwork. I have the film that we all know and love, but what I wanted to do was to not copy anything. I wanted to have influence from definitely from the books, and take it to a place that create a place that I would want to go see. I would want to pay money to go see and be immersed in this world myself. In this film, I wanted to take us to a bit of a brighter place. So we do have dark elements in our film, but at the same time, I wanted the audience to be on a roller coaster ride and around every corner experience something new. And I think we're achieving that. I've always been a believer that the environment dictates what the mood is at that particular moment. And I think in our film, I've tried to pay attention to what's happening in the storyline so that the environments are appropriate for that particular situation with the actors. I decided early on that I wanted Emerald City to be a very masculine place, very strong, hard lines. And in Glinda's world, I wanted a much more curving feminine quality, so I chose Art Nouveau as a sort of infusion into the sort of castle motif that we know, classic Disney castle motif. And I think it's important, it's an important way to define, and all these things are very subtle, but they're important over time. When you're watching a movie, you don't sort of understand why you feel a certain way, but there are some ways that a production designer or director can steer how the audience feels without them knowing that they're on the trip. And but those, and I also love those two styles. There's some Victorian mixed in with that, and some of our own fusion of different types of styles. And it's really a potpourri of styles, but it's intentional, so that the audience can feel that they've come out of one look and into another.